speculations on God and other paranormal phenomena is an example of the grounded, humble, non-discriminating mind's potential to contemplate or assimilate ineffable knowledge. For example, concerning the concept of God, i.e. the many mysterious ways in which God works, though we're driven by an inexplicable force, its intelligence can be described as being a scattered one, not higher. It doesn't adhere to a divine plan or to a greater design. Rather, its amorphous hand is drawn to a kind of chaotic magnetism. This self-exploratory improvisational consciousness sketches out reality for the purpose of meeting extremes and resolving contradictions, or to work with them in a less conflicting manner. Simply put, on a raw energetic level, this force, or sometimes forces, also struggles with the base paradox that torments us, which is how to unify the positive and negative for the sake of enlightened progression, not oppressive or dehumanizing evolution. In this respect, this paradox potentially can also be the most liberating paradigm. It encourages us not to invent something pure, original, and discriminatory, or to repress new ideas. Rather, it stresses that we see the interrelationship, interdependence of unique things, both traditional and innovative. The unfortunate tension between tradition and innovation or progress has thus far led to bias, frustration, prejudice, fleeting trends, generational and cultural clashes, war, and various conflicts. You get the idea. Unifying the positive and negative will also help us understand that the greatest power is non-oppressive and is therefore non-compromising, which will pave the way for a more integrated yet freer existence. Ultimately, all conflicts, whether between good and evil, God and Satan, opposing belief systems, various deities and beings, etc., arise from a single, yet conflicted and divided, multidimensional consciousness, which is overwhelmed by its diversity, as opposed to being integrated for the purpose of exploring infinite possibilities with little or no compromise. In this sense, the divisive contradictions can be converted into multipliable options. For instance, our inability to fathom outer or distant phenomena such as ETs and other mystical things is symptomatic of our cosmic disharmony. Malignant beings such as aliens and demons are merely our unaligned parapsychic selves or doppelgangers, manifestations of a schizophrenic universal mind or extensions of multidimensional consciousness and its corresponding realities. a trans-dimensional reality that can either be an all-inclusive paradise or ever-deepening hell, according to our hopes and fears, our development or regression. In other words, all beings, all consciousness have the potential to bypass their rigid laws of good and evil and evolve into beings more integrated than gods and angels and inhabit domains more substantial than heaven. For great gods have even greater limitations. Hence, this God force, which mirrors human development, is at a conflict with itself, because, like us, it wants a stable space to reside in, yet it also desires continuous exploration and boundless expansion. This force becomes divided in its chaotic or blind search for stability, becoming a faint spectrum of its multidimensional essence as it inhabits a lower density realm or is drawn to evolving consciousness in the form of an oppressive, godlike power source, narrow belief system, constraining paradigm, physical or evolutionary dynamic, law, etc.